Hi everyone, it's V here, and this is a quick-ish news break about TLD and all things TLD, essentially. Do not worry, we are still attempting to release bi-weekly, with Kino being slotted in where we can, and you may have noticed we dropped the Beyond the Eclipse episode today. So that gets us caught up on Beyond the Eclipse at least. So just no panic, we are still releasing as best as we can the same sort of schedule. So that was like the worrying thing I didn't want anyone to worry about. Like, oh my God, we're stopping. We're not. We're still continuing doing the same thing. So there is actually kind of a couple of things that we've been working on the background that seem to all come together about the same time. So I thought I'd do a news break and get everyone up to date on various things. First of all, Blighthouse Studio. You may actually have heard this a few times. Blighthouse Studio is the kind of production group that we decided to put Four Top Threes, which is a podcast featuring myself, Neil, Athel, and Kessie. We've been working with Kessie a bit to help it with Counterbalance, and we decided to make a podcast, and we spoke to the rest of the TLD crew, and we spoke with Kessie in a more serious way, and we decided to make Blighthouse Studio a thing which is for all of us. So essentially, we all get to work together making more podcasts or more Twitch streams or more YouTube things together. Essentially, it's a way for all of us to pool our resources, our talents, and to help us and our friends to make shows. So that's kind of the big announcement is Blighthouse Studio. You'll probably hear it tagged onto the end of the episodes fairly soon. You'll probably see a tiny little logo appearing on our various shows. But yeah, that's a thing that we're doing now. Blighthouse has already had Four Top Threes. We have Counterbalance there, and TLD is now also under the same umbrella, which is really rad. Or if you like to think of it, Counterbalance and TLD are moving in with Four Top Threes, and we're having a bunch of new rooms fitted out so we can basically have new projects together, which is kind of fun. So that's kind of one of the major things. You may be asking, how is that going to affect things like the show? It shouldn't affect our show at all, really. We should still be producing it, so that would be great. We also, however, will probably be affecting the Patreon. The Patreon changes, there'll be a couple of them. First of all, the Patreon will be supporting three shows. It'll be supporting TLD, Counterbalance, and Four Top Threes. So the Patreon, there'll be extra content from all three shows and be made a little bit more generic. So it covers these three projects and any new projects we're thinking of making. So for example, the Not a Pete Fund will be the Not a Pete Fund, but for people, places, pests, and plants across a lot of the things that we do. So some of the things we have, we might have some new RPGs that we're talking about making, new tabletop things, and also some other audio scripted things that we're talking about, and even some more talk shows, a bit like Four Top Threes. So yeah, Not a Pete will kind of cover a lot of things. So feel free to expand out the names and choices that you have. And also it means that I am not pushed to try and include nearly 150 spare Patreon names at this point. So yeah, so there'll be some odd little changes like that coming, and some bonus contents and blooper reels and all that for some of the other shows that we have coming up and the shows that are now under Blighthouse Studio. The Discord will have two new discussion channels, and if you're not on the Discord, I highly encourage you to come join us. The community there is amazing, and I'm going to forever, forever shout my love for the mods that are on there. They do a fantastic job. We hang out there on occasion, and we drop information and lines, and we talk about this, that, and the other with y'all. But the Discord will have two new discussion channels, one for Counterbalance and one for Four Top Threes. So that will kind of become a bit of a hub for some of those shows as well, which will be kind of cool. So talking about catching up on Patreon stuff and the fact that we are now up to date on Beyond the Eclipse, I don't know if I'd mention this, at least on the main feed, but the amazing Karen Heimdall, who is the writer for Y2K and Chaker, is also the voice of Eleazar, is also playing a character on Kino at some point very, very soon. They started picking up some of the writing for the backstories because, frankly put, I suck at it and I find it really difficult to write scripts, but I'm good at story. Karen very thankfully accepted our offer to be paid to write for us, and they did. They finished Kythea's story a little while ago. We've finally gone through the rest of the edits. So if you check out the notes of this podcast episode and you go check our website, theluckydie.com, and basically anywhere where you might find us, there will be a link to the audition pieces for Kythea's backstory. We have one character cast, and that's me. All the rest are open for debate and discussion. So yeah, if you wanted to be part of Kythea's backstory, please, please, please go ahead, read the side, send us auditions for whatever you like. All the notes will be included somewhere in the audition pieces. And yeah, the deadline for submitting those is the end of November, so November 30th. So you've got some time to record, read over, and send your lines in to us. All the information will be on the side. So I'm really stoked because I really like the story and I really like the way that Karen has written it, or Karen wrote it. I don't know which I'm supposed to use. It is awesome anyway. So I'm really excited to see this coming to life. And Karen is hopefully about to start on Caden's backstory. So we are in the process of catching up with things and getting our way through it. So I wanted to mention that, yeah, another big announcement is Kythea's backstory is ready to be auditioned and hopefully recorded very, very soon. All right, on to the other kind of thing, that about talking about all the things that seem to be coming together all at once. We have a bunch of new merch that we were working on, and we're just waiting for things to arrive, and they all kind of arrived roughly the same time. So the mirror art that Ketty has been working on for a while, and it was delayed due to life stuff, as we will understand. The mirror art for Laffian, Squash, Zoltana, and Rao, they're all completed, and they are effing gorgeous. Absolutely beautiful. And you can find them on our TeePublic. You can order them as tapestries and put them on mugs, on things like that. They're not on the t-shirts because they look trash on t-shirts because it's a square rectangular image and Ketty really hates their art being used like that. So we decided to listen to its wishes and they're not on t-shirts, but you can get it on a bunch of different things and they are absolutely gorgeous. I would highly recommend looking at those. We also have the previously patron exclusive Skullivers, which are Skullivers but themed to the different characters, and we had them on the Patreon. We were hoping to keep them on there for a year and then put them in and change out the artwork for the patrons. Fortunately, Patreon doesn't work like that, but nobody ever told us that. So we held on to it for much, much longer than we wanted as an exclusive there. And they're now available, each of those individual ones, again, as images that you can put on basically anything you want in TeePublic, with the exception of the masks. We think that's uncool. Mostly because you don't want the Lucky Die written on a mask, and we don't want that on a mask because we think that's awful. So yeah, the Skullivers, Laffian, Rao, Squash, Zoltana, they're all available to put on various things. You just need to go to our TeePublic and there should be a link. We also, in our Etsy store, have a bunch of all of the existing stuff. We still have some 3D printed Skullivers. We still have charms and pins of the Skulliver itself, of the whale, of a bunch of other things in there as well. But we finally did it. And we actually have cards. We actually have a deck of playing cards, which include artwork done by Nadia Tolliday, who is a fantastic artist, and she did us an entire playing deck. So all the suits have been replaced with icons that are specific to each of the characters, and all of the face cards, like the King, the Queen, the Jack, and the two Jokers, they are characters from the story as if they were drawn by Talis. And they're amazing. So we have this amazing set for Rao, which is Rao, Aimer, and Talis, and they're really cute. We have Squash, Trempel, and Demi, and Squash looks like horrific and it's amazing. Laffian, Kythea, and Caden. And Kythea is the cutest. I absolutely adore her. She's so cute. We have Zoltana, Odette, and Damaz. And Odette is beautiful. She's exactly what you think in a goddess. And Zoltana has such an attitude about her. It's amazing. And for the Jokers, we clearly have Daichin and Emil, because Daichin is Daichin, smarmy as he is. And Emil, who is probably the most voice actor we have on the show. So we could not put them on there. And they're amazing. And they come in this really nice, like, green lucky die box. The quality of the cards are really good. We only have a limited run of them. We only have 30 of them. We also have available jackets with Zoltana Splasher on. And again, go check out our Etsy store. They look dope as fuck. Casey and I finally got them arrived. they're amazing. Go check them out. So yeah, I guess the back end of this is like merch. We have cool stuff. Please go check out the links. Anything you buy helps support us there. And I would also say, and it's not on my list, please go check out the Bandcamp. And there's a bunch of music from the first series and kind of like the earlier part of that. Everything you buy on the Bandcamp goes straight to Neil because he worked really hard on that, and we think he should be rewarded for that really hard work he's done. So yeah. Oh, and Swobolds. Go check out the itch.io link to Swobolds because Arch wrote it, and it's a pay what you want, and it's great, as you may have heard in one of our New Year's episodes. Go check it out. It's great. I think that's kind of the gist of it, really. We're still releasing best as we can, as quickly as we can. We're now Blighthouse Studio. Your Patreon will support all the crazy things that all of us want to do in doing that sort of things going forward. There will be discussion channels on the Discord for the other shows that we have. Kythea's backstory is ready to be auditioned. And there is a bunch of merch which looks rad as fuck. So, yeah, I guess for a news episode, that's kind of it, really. Thank you so much for listening, guys, and I hope that you enjoy your week. Bye.
Hello, Ariel. Did you want to listen in on me and Rock enjoying ourselves?
Don't encourage.
Should I describe to you what we're doing right now?
Picasso? Huh? What's going on?
Let's see. Look, these wind shells document anything you do in order to banish the spirits.
I don't banish spirits. I'm fixing the tango.
Of course, we can't open a new hole into the Aetherweb every year.
But spirits aren't always bad.
Those are exactly the reason Tangleweeds happened in the first place.
I'm sure Rocka knows how to get through a water gate without disrupting the magic balance.
So what happens when there's a hole in the weave? Does magic pour out?
It is already broken! Let more of air into this world! I'll destroy one of them!
You've fed enough already!
I will kill you, you filthy
whoa, little... Whoa, calm down, Rocka!
Try it, Feather Duster!
God, ferocious rune master! Your friction will grind the weave a twain!
Hjarta. In moments like these, I wish I could see the runes.
What's wrong, Rocka? Is that Tangleweave maybe too difficult even for someone as great as you?
Counterbalance, a high fantasy audio drama. Subscribe to us on iTunes, Stitcher, or wherever you get podcasts from.
Welcome to Four Top Threes, where four friends list our top three favorite things about a random subject of choice.
You might be wondering, hey, I already have like 75 other podcasts that is basically just four people who are friends talking bullshit at each other. Why should I be listening to this? We are actually from four different countries, so we are hoping to bring four different perspectives on all of these topics that we are about to choose.
You throw Lion King out there like a dirty rag and then you pontificate over Lilo and Stitch?
That was very good.
I thought you tried to give them back.
No, purchased
a month of milk and bananas. Could I return them? I haven't opened them yet. Spent the night with two of the milks.
Turkeys could talk. That sound like Mr. Meeseeks. I wasn't made to live this long. Kill me.
Oh, no.
Oh, president turkeys. I love it.
Oh, fuck my face.
You can find Four Top Threes wherever you find your podcasts, and we release at the end of every month. See you then.